It was April 6th, 1917, when President Woodrow Wilson declared that the United States would enter the First World War. Able to muster an army of only 100,000 troops, the military would institute a draft, plucking able young men from every walk of life, including Major League Baseball. Household names like Ty Cobb, Christy Mathewson, and shoeless Joe Jackson enlisted and bravely served in battles across Western Europe. Back home, the 1918 season was cut short by the war, and for the only time in its history, the October Classic was played entirely in September. A subdued crowd gathered for Game 1 of the World Series at Chicago's Comiskey Park to watch the Chicago Cubs take on the Boston Red Sox. Now, both teams' rosters had been depleted by the draft. Red Sox manager Jack Berry had enlisted, and that forced team executive Ed Barrow to manage the series. In a move that would change the course of history, the shorthanded Barrow was forced to play the Red Sox top pitcher in the outfield between starts. That pitcher was 23-year-old Babe Ruth. Though the games would be dominated by Ruth, the series' most enduring legacy belongs to a song. It was during the seventh inning stretch that the military band struck up an impromptu rendition of the Star-Spangled Banner. Red Sox third baseman Fred Thomas, playing the series while on leave from the Navy, snapped to attention in a military salute. The rest of the players turned to face the flag with their hands on their hearts. The fans soon followed, and as the band played the final notes, the whole stadium was joined in the melody. The thunderous applause at the song's end was far greater than that which greeted any of the athletes that evening. Even though the Star-Spangled Banner would not become our national anthem for another 13 years, that moment marked the birth of a tradition. Join us as we remember these stories and more during the centennial commemoration at the National World War I Museum. For more information, visit theworldwar.org.